Tayler goes to cover Black, and Black isn't waiting, and they've left Bedford now. Bedford doesn't seem to be able to speed up, and Black has really made a long go for home. The question really is, has he gone too soon? Because Taylor's quite capable of going, as he shows now. And this is a piece of testing by Tayler, who moved up to Black's shoulder just to let him know the threat is there and the power is there in the black vest of New Zealand, which hits the front. And Juma has been dropped slightly, and for Bedford there doesn't seem to be a hope of a medal now. He's back 30, 40 yards behind the leaders, beaten in the closing stages once more for pace. It's Tayler New Zealand at the shoulder now of David Black of England. Juma closing up. Blackie Stewart, the champion, being lapped. He's got three to go, and these boys have got two, and the gold medal seems to be between England and New Zealand. It's Black for England. Taylor still so happy on the outside, and there he goes. Can Black respond? He's gone very early. He's given Black a chance. Black undoubtedly has a chance if he's got anything left, but Taylor's the man going away. Black can't go, and it looks like the first gold in the track events for New Zealand. Taylor now 6-7 yards clear of David Black, and Black doesn't look to be able to get back. He's beginning to close again, but no doubt here's an athlete following the steps of the Snells and the Halbergs at the Commonwealth Games, as Richard Taylor takes the gold. David Black for England the silver, and Juma of Kenya will get the bronze.